Px is an idea. If it has all finite sets in there, it's closed under unions and closed under subsets, and the whole set is not in the idea. So the concept of the ideal formalizes the notion of smallness. Elements in the ideal are regarded as small, and the complements are large. So, well, ideals on countable sets are very interesting. They appear quite a lot. So it's useful to have ways to compare and classify them. There are several ways to study them. For example, we have the Tukey order, the Rudin-Kistler order, Rudin-Frohlich order, and the Katetov order, which is the one in which we are going to focus on this talk. Okay, so we have X and Y, two countable sets, I and J ideals on X and Y. Then we say that a function, in this case from Y to X, so we can write it. It's a function from Y to X. So this is a Katetov function if the preimage of the elements in R are in J. So you can see that it is like the same definition as continuity. In topology, well, we care about open sets, and the definition of continuity is that the preimage of the open sets is open. And now here we care about the ideals, so it's the same idea. The preimage of these guys are in here. Katetov plus is we require the function to be finite to 1, and we say that I is less than J if there is a Katetov function from Yj to Xi. So it's like you shift the order, and the same with the Katetov plus relation. Okay, so whenever you have a new definition, the point is who cares? Who cares about that? Why is the Katetov order interesting? Well, it has many nice applications, and there are two that I want to talk about. One is that it is useful to classify non-definable objects like ultrafilters, and it is also helpful for understanding the indestructibility of the forces. Okay, so the first, classifying ultrafilters, we have the dual notion of an idea, which is a filter. So a family is a filter on subset of X. If X is in there, the empty set is not. It's closed on the intersections, closed on the subsets, and for this talk, let's say that no finite sets are in there. And ideas formalize the idea of being small. Filter is like a notion of largeness, and if we have these notions are dual. If we have a filter on the natural numbers, the dual ideal of F is defined as F star to take complements. And of course, this is you start with a filter, then if F is a filter, then F star will be an ideal. An ultrafilter is a maximal filter, which, as we know, they exist, but cannot be constructed in an explicit way. Yeah, but even though you cannot construct them, then they are super important in set theory, topology, functional analysis. They appear everywhere. Okay, So now the interesting thing is that many of the usual properties of ultrafilters can be expressed using the Katetov order and some definable ideas, and often are Borel ideas of low complexity. So, for example, an ultrafilter is Ramsey if and only if the dual is not Katetov above any Borel filter, every Borel idea. Being a P point is the same as not being above fin cross fin. So, just fin cross fin is this is an ideal on omega cross omega, and the generators of the generators of the ideal in here is you take a function and you choose finitely many columns. So finitely many columns and everything below the graph of the function. And these guys are the generators of the ideal. So being a p-point is equivalent of not being Katetov above fin cross fin. Being a q-point is the same as not being Katetov above, Katetov plus above an ideal called fin. Being rapid can be characterized as not being above an analytic p-ideal. And being a lower dense ultrafilter is not being above the lower dense ideal. So, the lower dense ideal, this is an ideal in the rational numbers, which is the ideal of lower densities. Ideal of lower densities of the rational numbers. So most of these characterizations are, in fact, are easy to prove. So then the important thing is that with the Katetov order, we can classify the ultrafilters using Borel ideals. So these ultrafilters, which are non-definable objects, we classify them using Borel ideals. And in all interesting cases, even the complexity is quite small. Okay, so another interesting thing about the Katetov order is forcing indestructibility. So we say that an ideal is tall if every infinite set of the natural numbers contains an infinite element of the ideal, or there is an I in A such that the A intersection X is infinite. And then we say that the forcing notion P destroys the ideal I if it adds an infinite subset of the natural numbers that is almost disjoint with every element of I. Another way to say it is that I is no longer tall after you force the I. Okay, so the theory of destructibility of ideals is this is very interesting, very important in forcing theory, since many important properties regarding many important properties of a forcing notion can be stated in these terms. So, for example, a partial order adds a new real if and only if it destroys an ideal called the trace of countable. Adding an unbounded real is the same as destroying the trace of K sigma. Adding a dominating real is the same as destroying the trace of the labor ideal, which is the same as destroying fin plus fin, this guy. And adding an eventually different real is the same as destroying ED. Yeah, so then there are many definitions in here that I don't, they are not necessary for this talk, but this trace of countable, trace of the labor ideal. But the important thing is that important notions, important properties of a forcing notion, they can be characterized by destroying a certain idea. Mm-hmm. So like, well, I mostly work on set theory of the real, so usually the forcings I work on are reals. And when you have a forcing, you are that adds reals, you are always interested in when it can add dominating reals, when it adds unbounded reals. And all of these notions are equivalent to destroying certain definable ideas. Yeah, which they are sometimes co-analytic, but they are quite definable. And then the Katetov order is a very important tool that helps us understanding the destructibility of forcing. The destructibility of ideas. So for example, an easy lemma is that if you have two ideas, I and J, such that I is Katetov below J, if a forcing P destroys J, then it also destroys I. So if you destroy a certain ideal, then you destroy everything below, Katetov below that ideal. And furthermore, we also have the following. You have an ideal J, so the following are equivalent. It is equivalent that co-enforcing destroys J, and that J is Katetov below the nowhere dense ideal. So note that using the destructibility of ideas and the Katetov order, you can know quite a lot of co-enforcing, for example. So even if you don't know anything about forcing, you don't know what co-enforcing is, but using this result and with this you can if you look at the definition of these ideas, even without non-enforcing you can see that it adds reals because trace of countable is Katetov below there. It adds unbounded reals, it does not add dominating reals, and it does not add eventually different reals. So even if you do not know anything about forcing, using these two results you could prove many properties of co-enforcing. I do not know why anyone would like to do it in this way, but you could. It's a free country. And well, this result is stated for co-enforcing, but there are similar results for Sachs, Miller, and Leiber, among many other forcings. Mainly you need to have mainly you need forcings that are proper, that have continuous reading of names, and that are the form Borel of, let's say, 2n or whatever mod I, where I is a sigma ideal. So if you take a sigma ideal on the Cantor set, let's say, and you look at forcings of this type, if it happens to be proper and have what it's called the continuous reading of names, then there is a theorem of this sort. So the, when it destroys certain idea, it can be completely characterized in terms of the Katetov order. Okay. So then, these are the reasons why you consider the Katetov order to be. In fact, it was this about forcing indestructibility that made me to be interested in this ordering. Okay. And now, an infinite family is an almost disjoint family if the intersection of any two of its elements is finite, and a family is small if it's maximal with these properties. So, almost disjoint families and mat families have many applications in forcing, like almost disjoint coding. In topology, you can look at the Molucca Ishbel spaces. In functional analysis, it helps to construct balanced spaces and sister algebras with interesting properties. In the study of masses in the Cantor algebra. So they are very interesting. And again, you cannot give an explicit definition of them, but even though they have many applications. Okay, yeah, I said the classical result of Matthias is that there are no analytic mat families. And not long ago, Thornquist showed that there are no mat families in the classical Soloway model, and in fact many theorems regarding the definability of mat families have appeared recently. It has been very studied lately. Okay, so you have a mat family A. By I of A, we denote idea generated by A. What does this mean? Well, a set is in I of A if you can choose finitely many elements of A that almost cover your set. That means that the only thing remaining about your set is finite. Okay, and then a theorem. A simple theorem. It follows by the classical proof of B, that B is less than A, that if A is a mat family, then I of A is Katetov below phi cross phi. And so, for example, from this you can see that if a forcing adds a dominating real, it destroys phi cross phi, and then it also will destroy. Oh. Let me see if my cross is Troy. Okay, well, we say a forcing destroys a mat family if it is no longer maximal after forcing with P. So, and this is equivalent as destroying the idea generated by A. And we say P preserves A if it does not destroy it. So, yeah, so what I wanted to say is that then it followed by this result that if a forcing adds a dominating real, then it destroys every mat family. And if you have a tall ideal, then there is a mat family that is Katetov below that ideal. So, then the Katetov order looks like, in here you have the Borel ideals. And up here you have the duals of ultrafilter. And over here you have the not families. So, yes, this is the tall ideas. The duals of ultra filters are cofinal in the Katetov order, and the mat families are coinitial. So if we have two mat families, we just write A is less than Katetov smaller than B if the ideas are Katetov smaller. And okay. So now what do we know regarding the Katetov order on mat families? So then a very basic question is if there is a Katetov top. So we say that a mat family is Katetov top if it is Katetov above every mat family. A is Katetov top if for every B, mat family B, B is less than A. Okay, so what about these guys? Well, it's not hard to see that a Katetov top family would have size A. A is the smallest possible size of a mat family. It is easy that, to see that there are no countable mat families. And so now you look at the smallest possible size of a mat family. Then a Katetov top would have size A, smallest possible size. And it also would be the most indestructible mat family. So it means that, remember that if you add a dominating real, then you kill all mat families. Here is fin cross fin, and we say that all mat families are in here, below. But then, if you have a forcing notion that preserves one mat family, then it will also preserve the top. The top would be the most indestructible one. Okay, so the question is, are there Katetov top mat families? And so well, there shouldn't be, but we do not know. And this is something very shameful because it's such a basic question regarding the order of mat families. And well, having a Katetov top mat family would be something very, very strong, which should not exist. But we have not been able to prove that no such family exists. There are some partial results. So what is known? It is known Salvador Garcia Ferreira and Michael Krushev show that if you have E equals C, then there is a Katetov top mat family. In fact, that can be improved to show that if S is less than or equal to B, then there is no Katetov top. And some version of diamond B, which it doesn't matter right now what diamond B is, what the strengthening of that is. But there are some conditions that tell us that there are no Katetov top mat families. And in fact, in most of the usual models that are constructed, that we construct in set theory of the reals, there are no such mat families. So there are no in the Sachs, Miller, Leiber, Matthias. In fact, then it can be proved that if you take a definable partial order a definable proper partial order, and you do a countable support iteration of length omega 2 of that guy, then in that model there will not be Katetov top. So in most models there are no such families, but sadly we don't know if it's consistent. There shouldn't be, but we don't know. Yeah, so the question is it consistent that there are Katetov top mat families? And then, what about, instead of asking for Katetov top, we ask for maximality. So, a mat family is Katetov maximal, or K maximal for short. If whenever A is Katetov below B, then B is Katetov below A, in which case we say that they are Katetov equivalent. So now, before we asked for top elements, now just for maximal elements, and now the situation is different. So in this case, we know that such families may exist. It's consistent that such families exist. So under some, under certain principles, Arcega, Krushak, and Martinez show that if you have P equals C, then there is such a family. And in fact, the strengthening of that theorem is that if you assume B equals C, then you can construct K maximal mat family, and also by another thing called diamond. So we know that these guys may exist, but the question is if you can construct such mat family in CFC, and that is also an open question that we don't know. So question is it consistent that there are no K maximal mat families? So in here, a model to try this question is in the Cohen model. So in the Cohen model, there are no such families of size omega 1. But by the Cohen model, let's say that we mean that you add omega 2 Cohen reals to a model of CH, then it can be proved that in such model there are no K maximal mat families of size omega 1, but we do not know if they are of size omega 2. Okay, so then these are two very basic questions. If there can be a Katetov top, and if there cannot be a K maximal mat family. So, another type of such families are Cohen indestructible mat families. So, a question of during step runs, which is one of my favorite questions, is there a Cohen indestructible mat family? So, well, it was shown by Kunin that assuming CH, there is such family, and so Juris asked if you can construct such family in CFC. I know that if you don't want to talk about forcing, then you can rephrase the problem just as, is there a mat family such that I of A is not Katetov below the lower dense ideal? So remember that every mat family is Katetov below fin cross fin. So the question is if it will also be below the Noether dense idea. So, well, again, there are many partial results. There are coin indestructible mat families. If you assume that B is equal to C, this was proved by Krushak and Kurilik independently. Here is a step branch show that there is such one if you have omega 1 many coin reals. And there is also one on the diamond B. And as also from these facts is shown, you can prove that there are coin indestructible mat families in the usual models of set theory. So again, by the usual model, I mean that you take a definable partial order and you iterate it, definable proper partial order, and you iterate it omega 2 times over a model of CH. So in any of those models, there will be a coin indestructible mat family. But it is unknown if you can construct such family in CFC. Okay, so if you have a mat family A, by I plus A, we mean the collection of all sets that are not in the ideal. So that means that they are big with respect to the mat family. So we say that a mat family A is tight if whenever you choose countably many elements of I plus of A, there is an element in the ideal that has infinite intersection with all of them, that it hits all of those positive sets. So note that this is like some sort of generalization. Well, being maximal means that whenever you choose one set, one positive set, there is one element in I of A that has infinite intersection. That's equivalent of maximality. So tightness is just the countable version of that. So now it's not hard to see that every tight mat family is coin indestructible. Now, these two notions are not the same. Let's say on the CH, for example, you can construct a coin indestructible mat family that is not tight. But these two notions are more or less the same. Well, they are not, formally they are not the same, but if you have a tight mat, if you have a tight mat family, that's coin indestructible. And if you have a coin indestructible mat family, then you can find a tight mat family. So even though they are not the same, in terms of existence, they are equivalent. So then obviously we do not know if there is a tight mat family in CFC. And now there is a natural weakening of this property. So now we say that A is weakly tight if whenever you choose countably many elements, countably many positive elements, then there is an element in the ideal that has infinite intersection with infinitely many of them. So tight was that you have intersection with all of them, and weakly tight with infinitely many of them. So obviously every tight mat family is weakly tight, but in general they are different. In fact, in general weak tightness does not give you any type of indestructibility properties. So these two notions can be very different. Okay, so we know that it is consistent that dual type Mach families exist, but in this case we can say much more. So one of my favorite theorems regarding Mach families is a theorem of Hartke, Dilip and Juris that says that if you have S less than or equal to B, then a quickly typed Mach family. This is this was constructed using a method of Shellam. It's a refinement of that method. And well, Dilip has improved that construction to show that, in fact, if the continuum is less than Aleph Omega, then there is such family. And the result is more general, but that's the easiest way to say a particular case. So then, this, at least to me, this shows that there should be a, well, at least I think that there should be a weakly typed Mach family in CFC, but that's also an open question. We do not know if you can construct such family. If not, I think that many strange things happen, but we don't know. Okay, so, well, that's all, and thank you for